He's hard on toys. He tears up some toys, but I think he found something that he can't tear up. He's trying though. He likes to chew. He's got a few chew toys in his kennel, and I think that's probably why his teeth are looking so clean, because he's chewing on stuff. Down, down, down. Good boy. This is Dakota. We got Dakota from the Maricopa County shelter back in September. He was a stray, at large and underweight. The shelter people, they said that when they first got him, he was very wary of people and kind of growly, and you know, he didn't want anybody to touch him or nothing. But then after a couple of days, he figured out that everybody he was encountering was nice to him. So then he's very social with everybody. So we've come across strangers and kids, and he's not even really dog aggressive unless dogs are aggressive towards him. He's just all and facing away. Come here. Hey buddy, come here. Come here. Come here. Now sit. You gonna give me a shake? Okay, we can do down. We can do down. Yeah, Dakota, actually he behaves very well. Like I say, when we got him, he was still underweight. He was 89 pounds, and last time we weighed him was in December, and he weighed in at 104, so we put some weight on him, and we get him out every day, either myself or other volunteers. Somebody's here to visit with him every single day, with him and our other dogs. And they get out for a walk, and sometimes we take them to the park over at Tempe, as we did last weekend. And he's excellent in the car. He just jumps right in the car. We think Dakota is about 3 years old. Typically, that's about the age when dogs get abandoned. You know, because when people get them when they're a puppy, they're real easy to manage, and then once they turn about 2 to 3. Then they've matured and they're their own dog. And so, you know, unless you're ready for a big, powerful, strong-willed, intelligent dog, it can be kind of a challenge. We would like to place him with someone with some breed savvy, someone who's had Akitas before. But he would also work well with someone who's willing to learn and do some research and spend some time with him. We did place him in a home back in January. They had a female Akita there, an older female, and he did really good with her. But it didn't work out because the home where we placed him, they had a home daycare. And the noise of the kids, little kids, just stressed them out. One of our volunteers also has elementary school kids, and she's been here, and her kids are fine with them, but they're not screaming and grabbing at them and everything. And so, you know, if you're gonna have kids around the dogs, you know, the kids need to be trained and parented, supervised. Same with dogs. Dakota is very easy on the leash. The only exception is when he sees something running, like around here, we see bunny rabbits and we see quail and other birds and stuff. And he's got, you know, typical Akita prey drive. And, you know, you can never train that out of an Akita. That's just built into them. But he's interacted with some other dogs, usually through the fence. And sometimes when dogs are running on the other side of the fence, he and the other dog will run back and forth. So he likes to play. He's very playful. But mostly he's just kind of very laid back. I mean, the other dog that we have here at Heidi's Village is very high energy, but Dakota is not. He's completely healthy. The county neutered him, and they gave him a microchip, and he's also licensed. You know, we just have to just transfer the license to whoever adopts him. He's current on all his shots. Like I say, he was underweight when we got him, and he had a couple of hot spots on the top of his front legs, and those have all totally healed. He's a good, healthy weight now. Like I say, he is a big boy, 104 pounds last time we checked. He's a big dog, but he's very manageable. He has occasionally, in cars, climbed over into the driver's seat, usually when you stop and vacate your driver's seat, and he wants to hurry up and get out. So, but other than that, he behaves really well. He likes to look out the window and sniff. So I usually open the window a little bit and let him sniff the air going around and just watch his things going around. He's good company. He'd be a great companion. Like I say, he'd be good with another dog, another female most likely. I mean, we typically don't place same genders together. Not saying that it's impossible, but that's really not the breed standard, just because, you know, I've never seen any sign of any dominance from him. But a lot of times same genders don't work out. But we do know that he was good. He did meet another female several months ago, last year, and he was good with her too. He would be excellent as an only dog, or, you know, a companion to a female about his size. I personally like having more than one, because dogs can have a relationship with each other as well as having a relationship with their humans. But again, this is Dakota. Dakota is very, very sweet, very affectionate, and he is just looking for the right humans. Some place to call home. If you think you're right for Dakota, or you'd like to meet him, we just ask that you simply fill out an application, and then one of our volunteers will evaluate that, and then we'll reach out to you for to make some arrangements. Hey, buddy. Down. Down. No. No. No cheating. Down. Good boy. Here you go. Yummy snack.